Another function that exists in Excel is the XNPV function, and this addresses some of the concerns with the other NPV function. So in a similar way, we can go look for XNPV, and you'll see here what it asks. It says give me the rate, so I'm going to use that one there. What are the values? And unlike NPV, in this case we must include all the cash flows, including period zero. And the reason we can't do that is because when I go to, I've got an option called dates, and I can now specify by highlighting these dates exactly at what date did this happen. So the benefit of this tool is these don't have to be spaced equally. As long as you've given it the date, it doesn't really care whether they're the same or not. And you can include the first one, because what Excel will do is look for the earliest date, and that's the period it's going to work back to. So when I say OK, you'll see it gives me a number 9819. You'll see we don't have to make any sort of adjustments here. You'll notice as well it's slightly different answer from the original NPV calc. This is because this one is using exactly the number of days, whereas this is just assuming constant periods.